cases of fire gutting halls and dormitories in senior high schools have been rampant in recent times, with the cause left unknown in most of the cases. One of the most recent cases involves the boys' dormitory of the Opong Memorial Senior High School in the Ashanti region, which has left more than 300 students stranded. One can also talk about 290 students of the Bupe Senior High School in the central Gonja district of the Savannah region being asked to go home after a fire outbreak on Monday morning, destroying portions of the school's girls' dormitory. The incident started around 7 a.m. when the students were in classrooms, and reports say the incident also started in the morning while the students were in the class. The cause of the fire was also not immediately known. Also in Accra, dormitories have been burned down on two different occasions in the Bubiashi based boys school, Accra Academy. I don't know why we call it Bubiashi based Accra Academy school, but we have two gentlemen in the studio to help us understand this. But meanwhile, the Africa Education which has noted with concerns that in the past 2 weeks, fire has gutted key infrastructure and facilities of over five secondary schools in Ghana, including the Accra Academy Senior High School. The group says that in a statement called on the authorities of the Ghana Education Service, among other things, to liaise with the Ghana National Fire Service and their respective district security committees to organize school fire prevention and safety outreach exercises and to reduce these incidents of fires across the country. Gentlemen, good afternoon. Thanks very much. Let me start with you, Ms. Asari. So what really are your concerns now with these fires? That they started, or that there were no preventive measures put in place to ensure they didn't start in the first place?
Yeah, Africa Education Watch is quite concerned about the frequency of the fires, the timing, and then the response. These three things: frequency. We all know we are in a dry season. The dry season is normally a hotbed of bushfires, especially in the savannah areas. But what we are witnessing this year is almost a day-to-day account of fires raising down or gutting school dormitories. Between the 17th of January and now, Obuam Ponsem Senior High School, two dormitories gone. On two occasions there have been fire. Islamic girls in Wa, the school in Kokofu, in Ashanti region, and then also just yesterday or so, we pay senior high school. We have about five or six senior high schools affected by fires. Now, the frequency is worrying because within 2 weeks, and then also the timing. Now, we are inching towards the final WASI exam. Form 3 students are busily preparing for the exam. We all know the challenges of the double track school calendar. Yeah. It is so tight that the least obstruction will cause a disequilibrium because it is already a tight calendar.
Yeah.
And so our concern is that senior high school students in Bupe, for instance, Form 3 students will have to go home. And then same as most of the other schools, because there's no place to sleep. And so it may affect the quality of the preparation for WASI. And then finally, the next concern is the response. We need a more rapid response to these fires. In Bupe, for instance, I heard the traditional authority indicate that it took a fire tender from Damango to come all the way to quench the fire in Bupe.
But rapid fire response, that will depend on equipping the fire service
that's the point
more
I'm making.
In order to respond
exactly
to these,
that's the point I'm
situations.
Making, that our response must be swift, because it shouldn't take a fire tender from Damango to come all the way to Bupe to quench fire. What happened to Bupe? We have oil and gas installations in Bupe. And so if we don't have something as basic as a fire tender in Bupe to extend that to support to senior high schools there, then it means that we need to really look at our preparedness to quench fire or prevent fire or to fight fire from the perspective of the Ghana National Fire Service.
Right. We also have Godwin Kofi Kwamwa, a fire management consultant and managing director of Right Consult, in the studio. So from your understanding of fires, what would you attribute these fires to? human error or maybe obsolete infrastructure, old wiring, that kind of thing?
Thank you very much. I think all you just mentioned are some causes of these fire outbreaks. The students basically don't have any, you know, idea on how they should manage, you know, these fire situations. Secondly, we have...
Is it conduct themselves well to avoid fires, or when there are fires, how to respond?
How to conduct themselves to avoid fire, and even when there is fire, how to respond.
How to respond.
I think we've all been to secondary schools. Yeah. How many times were we given any basic training?
No, I wasn't giving any fire prevention in my school. I went to the same school with Mazar Zari.
And the situation is still the same. As we are discussing now, go to any school and find out whether you see a simple extinguisher hanging anywhere. We don't have
so the Ghana Education Service should be investing in things like fire extinguishers in every block.
Yes, that is it. I think a fire risk assessment should be carried out for the hazard points to be identified, and then the right or the prescribed fire system that could manage fire in various risks that are identified should be made available. And
but if we step away from our schools, do you get the sense that our overall fire awareness or fire prevention is very horrible as a country? I mean, how to respond in an emergency situation of a gas explosion, for example, how to respond in a situation where you see fire popping up from electric points, how to respond when you see fire burning from a corner of your room. We're that horrible, right?
Yes, I think the gap is just too huge because, one, I always say there is no clear-cut regulatory framework that regulates the fire industry in Ghana. We install fire systems, but what policy regulates us? You understand? And we need to identify that. And out of the regulation, like he was mentioning, in the Western region, we have oil drilling taking place and all those things. What provision have we even made in place when it comes to firefighting? Today we are talking about schools. Previously, some time ago, we were talking about markets. The next time, we'll start talking about ministries, where maybe ministry A, B, C is catching fire, then we shift attention to the ministries. But I think the major thing is, as a country, we need to have a clear-cut regulatory policy that should be able to, because that will clearly tell what we should do at the ministries, what we should do at the schools, what we should do at the hospitals. You go to hospitals, it's very horrible. And just imagine fire should get any hospital now with the sick people, you know, in bed. What happens?
Sorry, would you recommend that fire tenders are positioned within close proximities of public places like schools and hospitals?
I think
especially considering how dense our societies have become now.
Yeah, I think that is very, very basic, because in positioning fire response points in districts, such factors should be taken into consideration. For me, the critical issue is that he raised the issue about how fire conscious
we are
our schools, okay? How compliant are secondary schools to fire consciousness? To what extent are they compliant? Now, we will not be able to do that assessment unless the Ghana National Fire Service releases the reports of such investigations into fire outbreaks in schools to the general public and stakeholders like Africa Education Watch and TV3. It is only when we have copies of these investigative reports that we can follow up to ensure that the findings and, most importantly, the recommendations are adhered to by the Ghana Education Service in this respect. But in many instances, you find the fire service telling you that it is not mandated to make their reports public. In the same way, I'm telling the fire service today that it is also not mandated to hide their reports from the public. And so this time around, we are giving the fire service 2 weeks. If in 2 weeks it refuses to make the findings available, we will trigger our rights under the right to information law and demand the information, because without having access to the report of these fires, it will be impossible to hold the GES accountable to the basic things that the GES is supposed to put in place in these schools to forestall the reoccurrence
of fires. Mr. Kwama, I'll take your final word before we wrap up on this conversation.
All right. I will advise that we all know fire outbreaks are very disastrous. And so basically, we should look for the basic, you know, fire prevention and firefighting equipment to put in place. The first that will come to mind will be fire extinguishers, will be fire signages, will be everything. Like schools like this, we need a hydrant system that even before the the tender, fire tender drives there, the fire warden that are trained to manage fire systems there will begin to use the hydrant to fight that fire. So at least the disaster that may be caused can be reduced even before the fire.
Right, gentlemen, thanks very much for coming.